Hey everybody, Tim Norris here, aka GreyElephant.
And Carmen Norris.
And welcome to a live play by GreyElephant Gaming. What are we playing today?
Today we're playing Viceroy.
Viceroy! Hey look, we're board game models.
Surprise, that's right!
Yeah. This was sent to us by Mayday Games. Really appreciate it because, I'm not going to get into our thoughts yet. We will do that after the live play.
We appreciate filming this game.
The concept of this game is you're going to be taking cards and you're going to be building a pyramid out of them. Not a 3D pyramid where it goes up, but it's going to be going, you know, what is that called? Where it's just a 2D. It's going to be a 2D pyramid that you're going to be in front of you. And it's called your Pyramid of Power. I would say this is like a card-driven Euro
card drafting
kind of a game.
Engine building.
Yeah. But we'll get into our thoughts of what we think of this game
after the live play.
Now, she's been pretty conceited because she whooped me pretty good in our last game.
Uh-huh.
We played 3 games so far. I've won the first 2, and then she slaughtered me in the last game.
I finally have my head wrapped around it, and now the camera's on, so you know I have to win.
We're going
to
see what's going to happen. We'll put your money where your mouth is. All right, so we've got the game all set up here. At the start of the game, we are dealt character cards, 4 of them. We're going to select one to start our first level pyramid with, and then we are going to keep one in our hand, and then we're going to discard the other 2 back into the deck, shuffle the deck back up, so they can appear later in the game. Each character has different abilities depending on which level that they're built, so our first level characters will give us the first level ability, and in this case, I'm going to have a permanent green gemstone, and
mm-hmm.
Carmen was able to draw an additional either law or character card from this deck over here.
And I did choose a character card, so
and she
I
chose
have 2 in my hand at the moment.
Whereas I only have 1 at the start of the game.
Mm-hmm.
Now what we're going to do is we're going to go straight into the auction phase. Now, mind you, we will explain how all this stuff works as we're playing the game, guys. Trying to explain too much right now is just going to confuse you, to be honest. It makes more sense as we're playing it out. The other thing to note, though, is that we do have gems behind our screen over here. Now, we're going to use 2 screens just for the gameplay video so that we're not having to hold the cards and show the camera work at the same time. It'll make it a little easier. But just know, these gems here do not come with the game. The tokens typically will replace these. These were sent to us by Mayday just for the... because they were nice. That was really nice of them to do that. And they're actually pretty fabulous. I love them. The other thing that does not come with the game is this mat. You would typically just have 4 cards that you would put here, and then you would put the auction cards either below or above, depending on if it's first or second auction. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go straight into the auction phase. Now, the way the auction phase works is we have 4 cards laid out here. If you are interested in this card, you will secretly take a gem color that matches the color above the card in your hand, and then we say 1, 2, 3, and then we reveal the color of gem in our hand. If Carmen and I match, well, then we're not going to get the card, basically. Like if her and I both had blue, then we would both lose that gem, and then neither one of us would get it, and then we'd go into the second auction. And then if it happened again, we'd go into a third, and then if it happened again after that, neither one of us would just end up getting a character card that round. You had something that you were going to say.
Oh, no, I was just going to say I already know which card I want. So.
Okay, and then so what we'll do is we'll go straight into the auction. Now, one thing you are allowed to do is say, hey, I know I want this character,
mm-hmm.
so if you don't want that character, I would like to get it, so please don't bid this color, and then that way you don't lose out on trying to get, you're losing out on gem, basically, is what would end up happening. So... do you know which character that you do want?
I would like the Regent.
Now, see, I was looking at the Regent, too, because he has
that
ability right there. See, basically what you're going to be doing is you're going to be looking at their abilities, and depending on which level that you build them, that's the ability that you would end up obtaining. I guess I'd be okay with that. The other one I think I'd go for is Captain. So if you want to go Regent and bid red, I will go green and get the Captain. So
all right, let's do it.
So this is a great way. Now, one thing you can do is you can... you can agree that you're going to do that, but you do not have to follow through. So if I wanted to be a jerk, I could have put a red one down or a blue one. Wait a minute.
You went red. Yeah.
I could have went a red one as well. And then that way she would have lost a gem and I would have lost a gem, but she wouldn't have gotten the card. You would do that only if maybe you're dominating in the gems.
Right.
And you got a bunch because these are not infinite. They are finite. And since that, once they run out, they run out. You cannot put more gems into the game.
It's a limited resource.
Is it finite, right?
That limited resource is the board game talk that we use to indicate that.
Limited resource is the board game.
Okay.
So I would then get the captain. She will get the regent.
Yes.
Now, these two cards will slide up. Now, they will be available in the next round for us to be able to possibly purchase. And the way that you would do that is you would still bid the color, so like blue or yellow, and then you would have your choice of the two. And in this case, say like Carmen and I bid yellow, then her and I could say, well, I want this guy, and then you could have that guy. So what we're going to do now is we're going to add these cards to our hand, and we are now going to go into the deployment phase where we're going to start building our pyramids. So we'll show you how that works now. All right, so what we're both going to do is that we're going to try to build our pyramid of power. Now, the way we're going to do that is we're going to each select one of our cards. Law cards can be played for free anywhere in your pyramid of power, as long as they are either adjacent or built upon, and I'll explain what I mean by that as we're building. The other characters, you're going to have to pay gems based upon the color and the level. So, for instance, if I build, like, the captain here and put him level 1, where, like, right next to the baron, I would just have to pay the green gem, and then I would get the benefit. And then, in this case, it would allow me to draw either a law card or another character card from them decks over there. So, Carmen has already selected her card, and I think I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to select this one right here, and I am going to select it. So, Carmen, we both reveal, and now what we're going to do is we're going to look at our lower number. I am number 65. What are you?
I'm 53.
So that means Carmen will play her card first.
Okay, I have chosen to play the Pathfinder, and you can see here that it's going to cost me one red jewel in order to play it on the lower level. Now, obviously, I have to play it on the first level because
you can only stack. You have to build up to here.
Exactly. Now I can place another card on my next turn, but right now it has to go on the lower level.
Think of it if you are actually building a pyramid and you're stacking the stones. You can't have stones just hanging off of one another.
I'm gonna go ahead and turn in my red jewel, and now I'm going to get the reward for building that on the first level, which, as you can see, is 3 jewels. And so I'm just going to go over here, grab my red back, and a green and a blue. Put that behind my screen, and now it's over to Tim.
Now, my law card here can be played for free, and it says replace any card in your pyramid with this one. Move all tokens, if any, from the replaced card onto this card. Take the replaced card to your hand. You may play it as a law card in the following turns. So what I'm allowed to do now is I can replace my baron. So now I have an infinite green on my law card, and now I can take the baron to my hand. The baron now can be played as a law card, which means I do not have to pay the gems to be able to play it on my next turn. So kind of like a really awesome free action. Now, one thing you could have done is I could have probably played this later in the game where I had, say, like, you know, well, I'll explain that when the moment comes. So we're going to do this 2 more times of selecting cards, and then we're going to go back to the auction phase. So what I'm going to do is turn the camera off and give us a moment to, well, I know which card I'm selecting, but I know Carmen may need a second or so to be able to select hers. And what we're going to do is we'll come back when both of us have selected, and we will play them out. Okay, so Carmen has selected a law card. I've got up my character card, and we reveal. My number is 60. What is yours?
Mine is 88.
So that means I'll play mine first. So what I want to do now is keep track of these little circle spots, these little quarter circles, because that could play out not only for final scoring, but also benefit me throughout the game itself as well. And I'll explain what I mean by that when the moment happens. So it said here that I can play it as a law card in any following turn. So if you follow the rules of a law card, you do not have to pay the stone to be able to play this card, but you should still get the benefit, which in this case, I will get another infinite green that I'm going to be able to put on there. Now, what this means is that I'm going to have 2 stones that I'm going to be able to pay for cards to move from here, my hand, into my pyramid, but you can only do them once per turn. And what I mean by that is that we have 3 rounds each turn to be able to play cards in our pyramid. So hopefully that helps explain how those work. So they're very powerful, but you want to get as much variety as you possibly can as well.
Okay, I've chosen a law card, and really the main reason I'm placing this card is that I want to build up my pyramid, because I have this card over here that requires, I'm going to want to put it on the 3rd level.
Oh.
So that's one thing that law cards are good for, because you don't have to pay for them when you place them, and you can just start building up your pyramid. So I'm going to put it right here. And then at the end of the game, I gain 2 points for each adjacent character card
up to six cards can be adjacent to a single card. So if I play this right, that will give me 12 points at the end of the game, so it's not really a bad deal either.
No. All right, so Carmen has another law card, and I have a character, so I am number 59. What are you?
82.
All right, so that means I'll play mine first. So I have the first mate, so I'm going to place him right here next to my Baron.
Oh, look at all your matchy-matchy.
Yes, I'm trying really hard. You want to try to match as many as you can. He cost me a red gem to be able to play, so I'll take a red gem from behind my screen, and I'll put it over here. Now his ability is going to allow me to get three gems of my choice. I want a red one back, and I think I need a green one, and I'm going to go a second red. That would now be the end of my turn, and it would go over to Carmen.
Okay, I know I'm probably being way too picky with this, but I've got yellow over here, and yellow. I want another one to put here that's yellow, and so I've decided to use this law card because it's just going to allow me to draw one card from the small deck or the law deck. So I'm going to put it over here, match it up with the green.
I thought you were saying you were going to put it over here.
And then I get to draw a card, and then hopefully I'll get one that has a yellow. But then also, if you notice this, at the end of the game, I'm going to be able to fill this in.
Well, we'll explain that when we get there.
That's why this is better.
That's not a bad spot.
That's better than, say, you know, having two yellows and then two blues on top or something. It's going to be harder to fill in. So I'm just going to draw a card, and I think this time... Oh, this is a hard choice. I mean, sometimes the law cards are really
so
powerful.
Yes.
Do I want a law card or a character card? I'm gonna go law card. I'm gonna do it. Let's see what I got.
Was it worth it? Was it fantastically amazing?
No.
No.
All right, so now we are going to go to the next round, and we are going to select our auction cards again. I know who I want. I want the noble. Because the noble is going to give me a permanent blue one if I play him on my first level.
I also want the noble.
All right, so basically it's going to come down to if we want to waste gems trying to bid on him. So I know there's only four gems left in the pile here, which means that she has two and I have two because I have two behind my screen. So basically we could waste all of our blue gems on trying to get him if you want.
Yeah.
Or I can just concede and say, screw it, take the guy, I've already got two.
That's usually how it works because I tend to think too hard when I have to choose a different card than the one I originally wanted.
Now, the other thing I always look at is that these guys here are going to go to second chance. So it's not like I have to take one of these guys. Mm-hmm. It might sometimes be better to take one of these because you're always going to get a second shot at these guys the next round anyways, or the next turn anyways. So I don't want to lose my blues. I really don't. So I will concede that and let you have the noble, since I've already got two permanent. And I think I'm going to go over to this direction, possibly, and take that guy. So, all right, you ready?
I am ready.
I will go yellow. And
look, he didn't trick me.
And then you went blue. Okay, so I almost thought about tricking you. So there's your noble. And then I'm going to take the sentry. And I'm going to add him to my tableau. Now, what happens now is this character is going to go bye-bye. So she's gone. And then these guys are going to slide up. And then we're going to replace with four new cards here on the bottom.
Hello.
All right. So Carmen has selected a character card. And I have selected a law. My law is 80.
35.
That means you place first.
Okay. The character card I have selected is the guard. And I've already moved my cards over, so he's got room to just slide in right here on the bottom level. I have to pay a green. And then I'm going to gain this scroll, which is going to go right there on the card for in-game scoring.
All right, and for me, I fought the law in the... Law one. I'm going to place this law card right here. I created a circle.
Ooh, fancy.
If you do create a circle... 100, you know, and it's 100% the same color, you get a gemstone of that color, and you get to place it behind your screen. Now, this law card's given me three options. I can place a shield on this card, which shields will be explained towards the end of the game. I could put a six-point victory marker on this card, or I can take four gemstones of my choice from the reserve. I'm going to go with the four gemstones. Early in the game, gemstones are kind of important, in my opinion. So I'm going to go with a green. I'm going to go with a yellow, a blue, and a red. I'm just going to take one of each color and place them behind my screen. All right, so now both of us are going to select another card to place, and then we'll see who gets to place theirs first. All right, so I'm going to go with a second law card, and I am number 84.
18.
All right, you're first again.
I have chosen the noble, and it's another really simple placement for me because I really want this blue infinity stone. So I'm going to go down here. I'm kind of freaking out because I've got everything in level one here, but I get the blue infinity stone, and I need to pay a green in order to put that down. And there we go.
All right, and then for me, I'm going to place my next law card right here, and I've created another circle, and that gives me a green gem, and I'll place that behind my screen now. All right, now this one is a little tougher for me to decide on. Now it says I could place a +3 for scrolls on this card. What that means is at the end of the game, for every scroll that's in my pyramid, for instance, like Carmen has her scroll there, each scroll in my pyramid would be worth 3 victory points at the end of the game. It's very hard to pass that up. I could also draw one card from the small deck or the law deck. That would be over here. So this would be the small deck. This would be the law deck. These are your characters. These are more law cards. Or I could take 4 gemstones of my choice from the reserve. Ah! I'm doing okay with gems. I mean, I could take more just to take more. And I mean, it would be awfully nice to have more. So I've got a couple of cards still, character cards that I still have behind my screen. I'm thinking I'm going to draw a card. Cards are power, and I can't use my gems unless I have cards. So do I want another character, or do I want another law? I'm going to go law, and yeah, we'll see what I get here. So, Secret Service. not really thrilled about that one, to be honest with you. So I'm going to place that over here behind my screen, and now her and I are going to select one more time for this turn a card to place in our pyramid. She's got a law card. I got a character. I have number 12.
71.
Yeah, that means I place first. I'm going to take this guy, and I'm going to place you eeny, meeny, miny, moe, tiger toes. I'm going to place him on this side. That will cost me a red, so I'll spend one red gem. But in exchange, I will get 4 gems of my choice in return. So I'm going to go 2 reds, and I'm going, well, you know what? I'm just going to go, yeah, 2 reds, a yellow, and a blue. So, man, I am really dominating on the gems, so she can't have very many behind her screen. That should help me late game, but I've never actually played this strategy before, so we'll see.
This is the law card that I've chosen, and the reason I chose this is that I get to take 4 gemstones and put them behind my screen. I need this because if you look...
You have hardly any gemstones.
I don't have hardly any gemstones, and what I want up here is that I know I'm going to want to bid on this green card here because the it's going to give me an infinite gemstone, and so I need greens, and so I'm going to use this card, I'm going to place it, and I'm going to get greens with it, so let's see, where did I want to put this?
Well, you want to fill a circle in
it. Yeah, I can't. So I'm going to place it there because I know what other cards I have, and I get 4 gemstones. I'm going to take at least 2 greens. Let's see. A yellow. And that's going to require...
It will require a red and a yellow, so you might want to grab a red.
A red and a yellow. Oh, yeah.
So
okay.
There's a red there.
There's a red. Okay, well, there we go.
Now we go back to the auction phase. All right, so we'll move this to round 3, which really the game ends when this deck here, I don't know what the countdown little clock here is for. I think it's the same concept of how many cards are in this deck, so it doesn't matter. But the game can extend one extra round because there are some law cards which can extend the game. Regardless, so I know you want this guy.
I want that guy.
I know for a fact I'm out gemming you because I've got 2 gems in my pyramid. That's 2. There's 1 out here in the main, so that's 3. I know how many I've got behind my screen, which means I could outbid you for this. But I don't like to play that way, and you know I don't like to play that way. So I'm not going to challenge you on it. I will allow you to take that. So, like I said before, I hate seeing cards go away. It's so frustrating to see. It's like, oh, well, they're gone, and you don't get a chance to get those anymore. But there are there's 2 cards I like down here as well. But I know I'm going to be able to get another chance on them. So I'm going to go with one of these up here, either red or yellow.
it doesn't necessarily matter because what I want to do is look at their colors and also the bottom. That's the main thing I probably want to look at to see which one could benefit me the most. I'm going to go red. So red it is for me. So are you ready? I will bid red.
And green.
Then you did bid green, so I wanted to make sure that was in the camera, and it was.
Oh.
So I will take the strategist. You did fine. And then you'll take the Corsair.
I wondered what you were doing when you, like, moved my hand by my jewel out there.
So these three will slide up now, and then we're going to put four new ones out. And then we are going to select our cards. Ooh, an infinite yellow.
Ooh. Sweet.
Oh, and an infinite red. Oh, them are fighting words. All right, we'll select our cards, and we'll begin the next round.
Okay, so I am number 29. What are you?
One.
I'm number one!
Okay, I have chosen to play the Corsair, and I am really disappointed because I just cannot get my circles to match up at all.
No, you
so
can't.
He's going to go there. I'm going to have to pay a yellow and a red. So
I'll put your green infinite stone on him.
These get paid, and I get a green infinite stone.
And I already put it on there for you. So.
And for me, I'm going to put my strategist over here, and he would require one red for me to do that, so I will pay the one red to do that. In this spot where I placed him, he will be give me the magic scrolls, will be worth 2 victory points at the end of the game. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to obtain any magic scrolls, but if I do, then at least I know I'm going to be able to score victory points for them. Otherwise, they score you nothing unless you get these here. So we will both now select another card for the second round of this turn. Herman selected law. I got a character. I am number 32. What are you?
78.
Yeah, law cards are always pretty high. So I'm going to place the captain, and I'm just going to put him on the first level again. Now, he cost me a green to be able to do that with. I will use my infinite stone so I don't have to take from behind my screen. Whoa! And he is going to allow me to basically get another card. Now, I could go a law card or I could go a character. I'm going to go character. So if you could give me a character card. And let's see what I've got.
It's the best card ever, isn't it?
It is the absolute best card ever.
It.
You are so jelly. Okay, so now Carmen can play her law card.
This is an unusual law card. I usually discard this one for gems. If I were to discard it, I could just get 2 gems right now. And that's kind of tempting because I'm kind of running low on certain colors again, like
I would
always.
Say you are.
So I think I'm going to use it though because I don't know. I just think it sounds like fun. Anytime you take a law card, you may put it underneath this card. At the end of the game, gain 5 points for each card underneath.
Oh, that's the first time we ran into that one.
Actually, I had it before. I just discarded it, so you didn't know about it.
Oh, you completed a blue circle!
I can complete a blue circle!
Yay,
I get a blue gem! I'm so special.
You are special.
All right, that is it for
That's
me.
That's it. We go into the auction phase now again.
Silly me, we still got one more round in this deployment phase. So, all right, I am number 15. What are you?
52.
All right, so I will place mine first. I'm going to place the one I had just drawn. I'm going to put him over here. I will use my second green infinite stone to be able to pay for that. That's going to allow me now to draw another card. So I've got a nice base here going. It's about time I start building upwards. Law card or character? I want another character card. So if you would, hand me a character. I appreciate it. And, oh, best one ever!
I knew it.
I have chosen the Regent, and I will finally have a red Infinity Stone after I place this. This is why
nice.
I built my pyramid up. So I'm going to put him up, way up here, because this People's Quorum is going to give me 2 points for him at the end of the game.
Yep.
And Tim gave me my Infinity Stone.
So you would have to do a blue and a green, but you have 2 Infinity Stones.
I have a blue and a green Infinity Stone to use, and so now I just need to pay a red. So there's my red, and...
Yep.
Here we go.
Nice. Very good. Now we go into the auction phase.
Look at my fancy pyramid.
You are doing well.
All right. So I know I'm bidding yellow. So
I'm
going to go yellow. Because...
I'm also going yellow.
All right. Well, we'll just see who gets what then. I am going yellow. Did you actually go yellow? Yes,
I did.
She did. Okay. So that means there's 2 cards here.
Mm-hmm.
We can agree that one of us gets one of them, one of us gets the other, but if we can't come to an agreement, we both just lost our bid. I wanted the mercenary.
You wanted the mercenary.
Yeah, because he's got an infinite yellow stone down there.
I want that infinite yellow stone as well.
Well, and then plus if I went level 2, I'd get the scroll. But
Well, level 2 gets you a scroll.
Yeah, the level 2 will give me... I'll tell you what, I'll go veteran, I'll let you get mercenary. So, just because I'm a nice guy.
I was holding my breath.
Yeah, well, I know I could out-gym you because I went awfully crazy with the gems early in the game. But I don't like playing that way. If I was more cutthroat, then yeah. But I like games to be fun. If they're not fun, then what's the purpose, right? All right, so this round is set up. We're going to go straight into now our deployment phase.
I am a 58. What are you?
63.
I go first. So I'm going to put my veteran right here, and that would cost me a green and a blue. So I'll spend one of my greens, and then I'll have to spend a blue from behind my screen. Let's see. He gives me a magic scroll. So now I know for a fact I'm going to get 2 victory points for it. There was no purpose of getting it before that. Other than you can try to create sets. And what I mean by sets is that there are gears, magic scrolls, and then there's shields as well, which I don't have a shield on any of mine. Carmen might have one on one of hers. Plus there's swords, but swords go behind your screen. But for every set of scroll, gear, and shield that you'd have in your pyramid, you would score 12 bonus points at the end of the game. So that would be another purpose. But this gives you an extra bonus for your magic, or yeah, your magic scrolls.
Hey, I have the mercenary, and here's the thing. There's a choice to make, because I could place him on the bottom level and get a yellow infinity stone, or I could place him on third level, and if I do that, I get a shield and 4 stones. So, in this case, you kind of want to look at how many rounds that we have left.
Got a lot of rounds.
We have a lot of rounds left, yeah. So the yellow infinity stone will do me a lot of good. Now, if there were only 4 rounds left, it'd probably make more sense to go for this one, because I'd be getting 4 stones, you know what I'm saying?
Either way, I think it's a good card.
I think I'm going to put it on the bottom, because, you'll see why here in a second, because if I put it on the third, I have to pay a red and...
I don't have one. I can count stones.
It's gonna go over here. I don't have a yellow infinity stone.
She can use her red one here.
I used my red infinity stone to pay for that.
All right, so both of us decided we're not going to play any more cards during the last turn, and when that happens and both players pass, you just go straight back to the auction. So we are going to move this to 5, and I know I want the Huntress. So
I'm going blue.
All right, so I'm going to go green. Ready? All right, both of us are honorable people. So I will take the Huntress, and do you want the Chieftain, or do you want the Brigade?
This is a tough decision. If I go with this
guy... Well, you'll get a second shot at this one. And that's a lady, I think.
5 jewels.
That's a woman.
Is it? I don't know. Maybe it's a guy with long hair.
Maybe it is a guy.
I think it's a guy with long hair. This one, if I place it now, I could. That's basically worth 6 points.
That is awesome.
Possibly 8 points if I place this.
Take it.
So I'll take
it. I think he's a great card. I actually, that was the other card I was looking at that I probably want just because of the level 4 ability of getting plus 5 for magic scrolls.
Right. I'm not sure. See, the level 4 would give me plus 5 on magic scrolls. This would give me 8 points right there.
Yeah.
Because 2 points, I would take 4 away from Tim. And if
nobody cares.
That place there, I get 2 more points. So.
It's tough. It is a tough. But you know what? That's how all these cards work. Okay.
And of course, when I said nobody cares, I was just kidding. So I have selected my card, and Carmen has decided to pass already, which means that she's not going to be playing any more cards for this deployment phase.
Now, it's not good to pass because I have infinity stones, which are being wasted now.
Basically, but, yeah. Now, one thing you can do, just something we have not covered, is you could decide I don't want this card, and you could discard the card. And if you do that, you get 2 gemstones of your choice from the reserves to put behind your screen that could help you maybe build other cards that you have back there. So, well, I am building the Huntress, so I'm going to place her right here in this spot, and that will cost me a green and a yellow, so I will use my green, but I will have to spend a yellow. That is going to give me a red infinity that I will place onto her card. Now what I can decide is if I want to continue building. I do not. So I'm going to pass. Carmen's already passed. Now I'm going to pass. So we're going to go into the next auction phase.
All right. So now I know I want the armor because I want this blue infinity that I'm going to go for. Mm-hmm. What about... Oh, let's move that up. All right. What about you?
I think I'm going to go for the gunner.
All right. So let's see if we both are gentlemen. Yes, we are. And I will take the armor now.
And I got my gunner. He's... He's cute.
He is cute. I would date that. All right, so these guys are going to slide up, and now we're going to put four new cards down, and we're going to go back into our deployment phase.
I've chosen my next card, and it is number 9.
And I'm 37. So
all right, so I am first. I'm going to take this gunner, and he's going to go over here on my level 2.
That's going to give you a sword.
I have to pay a yellow and a green. I have a
infinite green.
Green and a yellow. So there we go.
And that's going to give you a sword.
I get a sword.
That'll be end game, and we'll explain what swords
do. It goes behind my screen. And then I also get to choose 3 gemstones of my choice. And let's see what I already have. I'm going to need one of these.
One of these.
I'm going to need one of these.
And one of those.
And let's see. What was I going for next? I'm trying to remember now. I got to look over here, see what gemstones I wanted. I will go for blue. We'll just make a
make
a quick decision. We'll grab a blue, and that will be the end of my turn.
Blue's always a good choice. And I'm going to go with the armorer, and I'm going to place him right here. That would cost me a blue and a green, so we'll spend my green infinite, and then I will have to spend a blue from behind my screen, though. And that would give me an infinite blue, so I'll just place it right on there.
Okay, so we're back. Both of us decided to pass. We're not going to play any more cards, so we'll move this to 7, and now we are going to go into the auction. No talking, huh?
Ba-ba-ba.
All right, well, let's reveal.
Oh, no.
We both went blue. Okay, so now we have to decide. Which one was you go? I was going for the helmsman.
I was going for the druid.
That works out fine, then.
Because so, it's going to fit here nicely.
Yeah, well, mine is because of other reasons, but you'll see what my reason was in a minute.
Mine was because of the matching the colors.
3 and 4, and now we're going to go into our deployment phase.
All right, my card is a 38.
Mine's a 51, so you're first.
So I'm first, and he's going to go right here because it matchy-matchy.
Matchy-matchy!
Look at that, matchy-matchy. I get it play green stone. Whee!
Matchy-matchy.
All right, and yellow, red, green. I have infinity stones for all of those.
Nice, that is really
so that
good.
Is free.
Yep, so yellow, red, green. Good job.
And what I get for placing this on the third level is this little bonus...
So each of your scrolls will be
each
worth
3 victory
points.
Each of my scrolls are worth 3 victory points. So right now I have 3 victory points.
All right, and I am playing the helmsman, and I'm going to place him right here. And that would cost me 2 reds, so I will spend my red infinity, and then I'll spend 1 red from behind my screen. He's going to give me a couple of things. I get a shield. Shields will block swords at the end of the game. Plus, they could be worth victory points as well if you collect the sets like I told you earlier. Plus, I'm going to get 2 gemstones of my choice. I think I'm going to go with 1 red, and I'm going to go with 1 green. And I'll put them behind my screen here.
I'm not happy with that.
Now, what we do is we're going to select another card for round 2 of this turn. All right, so Carmen is going to pass, but she does have a card she wanted to show you, and we'll show it to you because she wants to show you why she's not going to play it yet. I'm going to play my Secret Service. It says, put any number of cards from your hand underneath this card. At the end of the game, gain 3 victory points for each card underneath this card. I don't really like this card, to be honest with you. The only reason I kept it is for the purpose of just placing up here, and then maybe I can just use it to fill in gaps.
Ooh,
because I get to play for free. So I placed it there, and I will get a blue gem for placing it because I did complete the circle there. And then Carmen wanted to explain to you about her card real quick, so we'll let her do that while
look
the camera's
still
on.
Look at my hand. Okay, this is the card that I have to deploy, but I want to put it on level 4. And it actually would be really nice to do that. But the problem is, I have infinity stones for all these. And I already used them. I used them to place this card. So I would actually have to pay these 3 stones. I'm not sure I want to do that because it doesn't leave me with a whole lot. And then, I'm going to have to bid with those. So I think I'm just going to pass.
All right, so I have passed. So let's move this over to here. I want the recruiter. So if you're not... crazy about him, don't waste your gemstone.
Alright.
So, I'm yellow, you're green.
Yeah.
Awesome. So
I thought about the recruiter, but I'm going to go with this one, the Margrave.
Okay, so the fencer is gone. Slide these up. And we are on 80. So, 1, 2, three, and four. Oh my god, such good cards. This is so hard. This game is so difficult because you see such good abilities on these cards, and you're like, I want to put them in my pyramid! Okay, so let's go into the deployment phase.
All right, so I am 20, and you are?
64.
So that means I'm first. I am going to place this recruiter on the third level, so that's going to cost me a blue, red, and a green, so there's my blue, there's my green, and then there's my red. And I want to place him right here, which I'm not crazy about, but I wasn't going to be able to match those anyways, most likely. So third level, he's going to give me 6 gemstones. So whoo-hoo, I am going to grab 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... And then I'll decide my fifth one off, or my sixth one off camera.
And I have this chieftain to place, and I'm going to put him at the very top of my pyramid.
Oh, he's a level 4!
Now, you can go level 5, so this isn't the highest, but still, that is a 5 scroll.
Yes. Nice. Okay, so I need to pay a green, a blue, and a red. The green, the blue, the red, they get covered with my infinity stones, but I do need to put... Pay one extra blue, right? So yeah. There you go. And you can see what I have left. And look at my beautiful pink.
I know, it's really coming together.
All right, so we both decided to pass, so we're going to go to the ninth round. I want the herbalist. I know for a fact I want the herbalist.
I want the witch.
Yep, works out. So, bloop. All right. I like how we can just agree with each other. This is so awesome. So we're going to slide these all 4 up. She's going for scrolls. I know. She's got +8 on her scrolls right now. She's going to end up screwing me over big time. She created a huge, awesome combo in her last game. She's going to do it again. All right, so now we're going to go into our deployment phase.
All right, so I will play the herbalist. I'm number 3,
33.
All right, so I will place her up here at the top. So that's a level 4.
Woo!
Whew, so that's going to cost me 1 of each color. So I will spend the blue, the green, and the red, and then I will have to spin the yellow from behind my screen.
Did I get my yellow when I placed that?
I don't believe you did, so I will just give you that. Okay. That's what I was about to put into the pool over here. So that's going to allow me to draw 2 cards. Oof, that's what I have been lacking, I think, because I'm okay with jewels, but I need cards. I am going to take, I think, 2 character cards, if you would please.
Sweet.
Yeah, and then that's going to end my turn, and then it goes to Carmen.
I can't believe it's not butter. Okay, this guy is going to go right up here. And I have to pay a yellow for that because I have 1 of each color of an infinity stone. So this yellow is going to pay for him to be placed. And level 3 means I get a scroll to put on the card. And so now I have 2 scrolls.
Woo.
At 8 points each, 16 points in scrolls.
Nice. All right, so Carmen has decided to pass, so that's going to just be leaving it up to me. So I'm going to play the Hermit on this spot right here. That's going to cost me 2 blues and a green, so I will spend my last infinite stone, and then I will spend my 2 blues from behind my screen. And that's going to give me an additional +3 on my scrolls, so I'll put that marker right there. So now I'm going to get +5 for every scroll I have. Now we're going to go to the next round of this turn, and I can decide if I want to play another card. I'm going to have to think on this for a second. For my last, I'm going to play the Castilian. I'm going to play him level 4. And,
ooh.
Yeah, I mean, it's not super great, unfortunately. Because I will have to pay for... You know what? I'm not going to pay him, play him yet. I'm going to wait. We'll wait on him. So I'm going to pass. That way I can reset all of my infinite stones first. You already did pass. I already told you about that. So now we're going to go to the auction. I know exactly who I want on the auction. Do you know who you want?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Ready? Floop. All right, good. I want this guy right here.
I'm going to grab the warlock.
Oops.
All them scrolls.
And then we'll both now select which character we're going to play, and then we'll be right back. Okay, so I am number 23.
And I am 49.
All right, so that means I go first. I want to play this guy up here on level 4. And the reason I wanted to wait is because now I can use my infinite stones to be able to pay for him versus having to spend all that stuff. So I'll use the red to pay for 1 of the reds. I will use the green and then I'll have to use a yellow. So a yellow and a red will come out from behind my display here. Mm-hmm. That is going to now allow me to take 8 gemstones from over here. I don't know what colors I'm going to take yet, so let's just let Carmen start her turn, and I'll think about what colors I want at the same time.
Tim is killing me with the gemstones. Yikes. I almost took this guy right here. I should have.
Oh, we should. He would have given me him up also.
6 stones. I don't know. Yeah. I probably should have taken him. But now I'm going to place my witch. And as you see, she requires 1 of each color in order to put on level 4. I have 1 of each color, infinite gemstones, so that's going to be free for me, which is awesome. So I'm going to put her up here on level 4. And unfortunately, I didn't make a circle. I hate that so much. I'm going to get 2 scrolls. And I don't know if you heard my stomach growling. I'm sorry. I'm hungry, but we're going to finish this game first. So I am rocking out the scrolls now. We'll and see if I can do this.
I am rocking out the gemstones.
No, you stop rocking out them gemstones.
All right, so I've got my next character selected. Carmen has decided to pass. I am going to now play the sergeant. We're going to place him right here, and that would cost me my other green infinite stone. My blue one, and then 2 reds. So 2 reds from behind my screen. And that is going to allow me to take a card from either the law or the character. I want the character deck. So 1 card, okay. Please. Thank you. Best card ever!
I knew it!
Okay. Actually, it is a good one. You would have loved this one. Here, let me show you real quick. That's the paladin.
No!
Oh, yeah. Yeah, with what you got going on, you would have loved that one. So this would be my final card I can play, and I'm just going to go ahead and do it while I got the camera going here. I'm going to play the Berserker now, and I'm going to put him on level 4. And that now is going to cost a green, a blue, and 2 yellows. So 2 yellows, a green, and a blue. Put those over there. That's going to allow me to get 2 more cards now. I think this time we are going to go 1 law. Nope, 2 characters. I want 2 characters.
Oh,
1,
man.
2.
You're killing me.
We'll see. All right, now that would end it. Now we're going to go back to the auction phase, so I'll set the camera up for that so we can think for a minute.
All right, do you know who you want?
Yes.
I think I know who I want as well. The only problem is that I don't like the fact that I'd have to spend my last colored gemstone of that color for him. That's the downside. There's going to be this round and then just 1 more, basically. And that's going to be the end of the game. God, I didn't think about the fact that I had to spend my last color of gemstone for that. That really stinks. That kind of almost changes my opinion on exactly what I would like to do now. You know what, though? I've got to just kind of go with what my gut's saying. And, oh, geesh. You know what? I'm going to kind of change it a little bit. I'm not going to take him after all. But I will not take your art blaster, guys. So, you ready?
I am not worried because I get whatever I want.
Okay, so she used the sword. The sword ability says that when you use a sword during auction, you will spend it, and now she gets her choice of whoever. And the best part is she doesn't have to spend a gem to be able to do that. So she took the art blaster, so I did bid green, so I have to take the inspector. So now these cards are going to go away, and now these cards will slide up. And the next round is officially going to be the last round, which this is going to be super crazy chaotic to see how this is going to play out, to be honest with you.
All right, so I am playing number 8. What are you?
11.
Okay, so I will go first. So I'm going to play the paladin, and I'm going to put him right here. So that's going to make him a level 3. So I have to pay a red, a green, and a blue for that. So there's my red, there's my green, there's my blue. And then he's going to give me a +3 on my scrolls. So that's now going to be +8 for my scrolls. And then Carmen now will play hers.
I am going to play the Arbalester. And I'm going to use my infinite gemstones to place him on level 3. Or her, actually. Yeah, that's a woman.
That's a woman.
Look at the boobies.
Look at the
boobs. All right. Level 3, and I'm going to get 6 gemstones for that. So let's go over here. I'm going to grab 2 reds, 2 greens, a yellow, and a blue. I'll just get all my bases covered, I think. Let me look over here and see what I need. I could use a green for there. Maybe I should grab another green. I don't really see any use for yellow, really. So, Well, I'll decide that off camera.
So I'm going to place my next card. Carmen, you are passing, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So my next card will be the Inspector. So I'm going to place her on level 4. Oh, I got so much potential. I'm like sweating bullets here. That will cost me a green and then 2 yellows and a blue. So I can use my green here, but I do not have any more blue or yellow, so I will have to spin those from over back here. But that is going to give me 2 gears. So I'm going to place both them gears on her. So now what I've done is I've created one set. I've got a shield, a scroll, and a gear. Now to see if possibly I could still come away with another set would be fantastic. I am done this round. I'm going to pass, so I'm going to reset all my little infinite stones here. And we're going to go to the very last round of the auction phase. And Carmen, do you know which cards you want?
Yes.
And I'm passing. I will not take a character card this round. Now, when you do not take a character card and you say that you're going to pass only during the auction phase, you get in gemstones plus... You get 3 gemstones plus 1 extra for every one of these gears that you have. They're called science gears. So I'm going to get a total of 5 gemstones. Carmen, which character are you selecting?
I'm selecting the emissary.
All right, so take the emissary. That would cost you the green gem. All of these cards are now going to go away. Basically, this is going to be the last round of the game. So now we're going to select who we're going to play for the last 3 deployments of the game. All right, so I am number 28.
54.
All right. This guy is going to level 5. The swordsman to level 5. This is the highest you can go. And the way this works is you have to pay all of the lower levels. So I have to pay a blue, a red, 2 greens, and then I have to pay the blue again. So let's perform that first. So that'll be 1 blue, my 2 greens, my 1 red, and then I'll take a blue from behind my screen, and then that'll pay for him.
Out.
It did. I know. Well, I held on. I played my cards just for this purpose. So
okay.
Now here's my options. I get either a 15 pointer that I could place on him, a 15 point token, and I can just say, all right, he's worth 15 points. Or I get all 3 of the bottom, level 1, level 2, and level 3 benefits. That is what I'm going to select. So that's going to give me 2 victory points. So if you could put a 2 victory point, it's right there.
Right,
I got them all in a line there. Then I get 2 gems of my color. I get a scroll. So if you could put a scroll on him as well. And then I get a card. So I'm going to get the card, and then I'll select my gemstones after that. So I want another character card. All right. And then I will select my gemstones off camera because you guys don't really need to watch me do that.
Okay. I have chosen to place the warlock. He's going to go on level 4 because that's the only spot I have open at the moment. Well, I guess I could put him on level 5, but level 4 I think is a better deal for him. That's actually kind of a tough decision. So he's going to go level 4. That requires a red, a blue, a yellow. I've already used my infinity stones for that. I'm going to pay a red. And yeah, you're not allowed to take that red, though.
I'm not. I'm going to take a couple of blues, though.
And then I'm going to get 2 scrolls to put on him. Look at my scrolls. Rocking out
the
scrolls.
Look at my scrolls.
Rocking out the magic.
Rocking out the magic.
Right.
Holy crap! That's a lot of magic.
Okay, I have the emissary, which is the number 2.
And I'm 14. And she's forcing me to slide my pyramid down, which means she's going to put a level 5.
He's
going to
slide
up
his pyramid down so that I can put mine on level 5. All right. This is going to require 2 greens, which I did not use my green infinity stone yet. That's the last one I have left. So I need a red, a green, and 2 yellows to put this on level 5. I've got those right here. I will just slap them over there to pay for it. This will go up on level 5. Now, I am going to choose... this option here. So I'm going to get...
You did pay 2 yellows though, right?
Yes.
Okay.
4 gemstones, a gear, which the gear's not going to do me any good at this point, and a +3 on scrolls.
And then you can select your gemstones off camera. And that's not me being rude. It's just so that she can have time to think. So what I'm going to do is play the butcher. And he is going to go all the way up here at level 5 as well. And that's going to cost me... let me see. 2 yellows, 2 reds, and a blue. So there's 2 reds, 2 yellows, and a blue. So I will spin those. And then I now have the option again of either taking 15 points or I can take all the bottoms. I'm going to take the bottoms again. Mm-hmm. This is going to be a little interesting because what he's going to do is give me this. This token now is going to give me a bonus for all of my colored blues in my pyramid.
Three.
And I happen to have three, and I could possibly have more before the end of the game as well. I'm going to get a shield and then two gems of my choice plus a scroll. This is going to be a high-scoring game. So I'll choose my two gems here in a second based upon my last card when I look at that. And we'll go into our last deployment. And this is it for the game. So Carmen says she's out of cards, which means that I'll just finish up by playing this guy here. And he is my level 5 as well.
Wow.
I have never, this is the first game I have ever built three level 5 guys. This pyramid is
I've built level 5 at all.
So that's going to cost me two red, a green, a yellow, and a blue. And I have them all right there. All right, so once again, I can take 15 victory points or I can take all the bottom stuff. I'm going to take all the bottom stuff. So that's going to be a plus 3 for my scrolls again.
A shield.
Another shield. And now I'm going to get 6 total thing, which I know I want.
Gems.
That's 3 blues I'm going to want because I want to paint with them. And we'll show you what we mean by paint here in just a bit. And then I want a yellow. I've already got a green.
You got a yellow and a red.
Yeah, so what I'm going to do is kind of look around, and then it'll make sense here in a minute as to why I'm going to take a second.
Okay, so now what you're allowed to do that the game is over is you're allowed to take your remaining gems and paint the little sections in your circles. For instance, I could put one red here. There you go. Now I made a complete red. And this is all going to be for final game scoring, so it's important that you do it. And you want to try to go as high as you can because the higher the circle, the more value... Whoops, wrong one. The more valuable the victory points, so the more higher. And I've already put two blue here because I was trying to figure things out off camera. So I put one green there. Put one green here. And then I've got a yellow I'll place there. And then a yellow I'll place there. Woo! This is going to be a high-scoring game for both those. So now what we do, just like Seven Wonders, a lot of other games, it just has all the things, and you're just going to score it down. Now, mind you, I got to tell you what our first scores were when we played this game. It was 59-58. I won that game by 1 point. These scores are not going to be anywhere near that. So it shows that we have gotten a lot better with this game. So the very first thing we're going to score is it says, for each single colored circle in your pyramid, you gain power points equal to the level of the top card forming the circle, plus extra points from bonus tokens of the same color. So what that means, this red circle here is a level 5, because the top card is on 5. So I get 5, 10, 15. Now they're worth 4. So now we're at 19. We're at 23. 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47.
Wow.
Plus I'm getting 2 bonus points for each blue. So we're at 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55. That is...
That's the highest we've ever gotten.
That
for
is 50
circles.
Bucks. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Circle right. Met the square for a fact.
I've got 5. Okay, let's go. Let's do 4s first, because that's 12, 17, mm-hmm. 20, 23, 25.
And then you don't have any additional
bonuses.
I
don't have any bonuses.
Okay, now you get bonuses for your infinite gemstones. So for each infinite gemstone in your pyramid, you gain power points equal to the level where this gemstone is located, plus extra points from bonus tokens of the same color. So like this, once again, could add bonuses to any blue, which I do have one blue. So I would get 2 because it's on the second level, plus 2, so that's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I got 8 for my infinite. How about you?
7.
7. So right now, let's see, we're going to go to our law cards. These are the law cards, and you're going to gain victory points based upon if there was any end-game victory point, which I don't have any.
Mm-hmm.
I'm 0.
I get 2 for each adjacent character card, up to 6,
so
that's
2, 12. 4, 6, 8. Yeah, that's 12, you're right. Yep, so 12, and then that's it.
Uh-huh.
All right, lastly, we get victory... Well, not lastly, I'm sorry, but victory points for any of these little tokens, so I just get 2 points for that.
0.
Here we are. This is the big one.
Magic!
These are for magic scrolls. So I get 3, 6, 9, 10, 11 points for every magic scroll I have on my board. And I've got 1, 2, 3 magic scrolls. So I get a total of 33 points for my magic scrolls.
Okay, I also get 11 points, because you can see I've got...
Yeah, but you got a lot more magic scrolls
for
than me.
Each magic scroll, and I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 66 points.
Woof! That's not the best. Carmen actually did better than... Well, no, that is your highest, because you did 56 in our last game. Okay.
Okay.
Now we gain victory points for our completed sets. You gain 12 power points for every set of 3 tokens, defense, magic, science in your pyramid.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got defense, magic, science, defense, magic, science. So I got 24 points for that.
I got 0.
Yes, I like hearing that.
Yeah, okay. I needed a shield. I would have gotten something.
Last but not least are the attack tokens. So Carmen had like that sword token behind her screen. If she would not have spent it, now she would reveal it and she would say, "Ha-ha!" And she would attack me with it. If I did not have shields, I would lose 4 points for each sword she had. Neither one of us lost points
for
that.
But he had shields, so there was no point in me holding on to the sword.
All right, so give me just a few minutes. I'm going to tally up the score and we'll see who won this sucker. All right, you guys ready? Final score. Carmen had 110. Very respectable.
That is a new record for us.
That is a new record until we tallied up mine. 128.
Wow.
That is now the new high for us. And you know, the bad part is I think we could even do better. The more we keep playing this game, the better we keep getting at it.
That's what makes this game good.
We went 59 to 58 was our very first scores.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we doubled. I mean, that's just insane. So this game, I absolutely love it. I think it is phenomenal. I just absolutely love these combinations that you keep finding new ways of saying, you know, do you just go for the magic scrolls? Do you try to go for the combos, trying to build up to the level 5 characters?
You have a lot of choices to make as far as getting your points, but it doesn't feel too easy.
Yeah.
And I love the fact that it's got engine building, drafting, resource management, and it's mathy. I mean, this is just like the perfect game for me.
I think this is going into my top 10 for 2015, no doubt about it. I think it's a beautiful looking game. I highly recommend, keep in mind, the mat does not come with the game. I highly recommend that if you have to decide between the mat or the gems, go with the mat. I think it is phenomenal. The gems don't make that big of a difference, in my opinion. But you definitely want the mat. I love being able to slide them cards up and down.
Yeah, I think the mat makes a big difference.
This game to me is just absolutely phenomenal. I love, like you said, I love the engine building. You want to try to build as many gem producing cards as you can. Try to get those ones that give you the infinite gem stones.
That helped me out a lot. I had a game, one of our games, where
I didn't really
build the engine. I was kind of going for points too early in the game.
Yeah.
And
that'll backfire.
It didn't do very well.
In our last game we played, she was just so lucky because she was dealt 3 cards that gave her infinite gemstones.
Right at the beginning of the game.
1 law card and then also 2 normal cards.
Yeah.
And it was like, wow. And there was all luck there.
From there, your options
open up big time.
Exactly.
Because you're not spending as many gems. This game, I really went into it with the mindset that I was going to dominate the gems. And I really think it paid off.
Yeah.
Because I thought, you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to build characters that are going to do nothing but just give me gemstones.
I'm surprised because we don't, if we played Cutthroat in the bidding,
mm-hmm.
then in the auction, then I think that it would make more of a difference if you're really going for all the gems because then you
Then you got to realize I'm losing a gem as well. So that's going to make it to where I'm not building as many characters.
Right.
All I'm doing is just like that, you know, dick move where I'm like, haha, I made you lose a gem. But in my opinion, that takes the enjoyment out of the game. Now, you can play that way if you want to be more cutthroat with your game.
But you were able to score higher and build those 3 level 5.
3 level 5.
You might not have been able to do that if you had been, you know, cutthroat with the auctions.
I am really proud of my pyramid because I was able to build not only 3 level 5s, which is the first time I've ever been able to do that, but I feel like I had like a variety of things I went for. It just wasn't one thing. You know, I had the magic. I had the the three combos where it seemed like yours, you really focused heavily on the magic.
And to tell you the truth, every time I win that way, I almost feel like I cheated. I mean, it just feels like
this is too easy.
Kind of a cheat game, you know, because I just went for all the same thing. Yeah.
Yeah, this is, to me, one of the absolute best games I have played this year. And yet, so far, I put Fallen by Watchtower Games, Elysium, Asmodee. I'm going to put Viceroy in there, and I know I'm forgetting somebody, but those three games all deserve to be mentioned in the Game of the Year for 2015, because I can see this game will not leave my collection. I will keep this because I just love every aspect. This is what I love about gaming. Tough decisions, lots of variety, and those moments where you're like, God, I got to sacrifice this for that. I would love to be able to build this guy for the level 3 ability, but God, I got to put it there. And
we both love this one. So that's kind of rare anymore, to tell you the truth.
Yeah, it really is. So ultimately,
love it.
Yeah, same with me. This is a must buy. This is a must own game. The one thing I want to say too is I think it plays so well with two players. I mean, it just does. We have not played with more than two players yet.
I could see the dynamic changing with more than two players.
It could.
I think the auction would get more difficult. Swords would become more valuable. Shields would become more valuable.
That's something that I'm going to talk about real fast just so that you guys understand how the swords could work. Let's say if we were playing with a four-player game and I had maybe one shield, but let's say my opponents, all three, Carmen had, say, like two swords behind her screen, and each of my opponents, the other two, say they each had one sword behind their screen. My one shield would block one of those swords combined. All of my opponents would combine their swords, basically, and attack me. So my shield would only block one, which means three swords would go through, which means I would lose 12 points, because you lose 4 points per sword that'll get through, I believe. I could be wrong.
It is four.
So that is a bigger deal, I think, when you're playing with a bigger... That's a big deal when you're playing with a four-player group. But when you're just playing two players, swords don't really become a factor.
Right. So,
I guess they could. We've never tried it, though.
We generally have enough shields for it. The swords are only worth 4 points. When I put a card down, I'm expecting 5 or more points from it.
Yeah.
And so I don't typically go for swords because of that. So.
And another thing I want to talk about is the balance with the law cards. Some of the law cards do feel extremely powerful compared to some of the other ones.
Yes.
That would probably be somewhat of a negative, I would say. Because some of these law cards are just like, oh, wow, there's one of them. And I didn't realize how powerful this was, and God, I couldn't even believe it. In our last game, I started to think. One of the law cards allows you to pay 3 gemstones to steal a token off of one of your opponent's character cards, or just basically any of their cards. So I give them 3 gemstones, but let's say they built that level 5 character and they put that 15 token on there, I could steal that for 3 gemstones with that law card. I didn't realize how powerful that law card was until I just
heard it. You could have stolen my plus 5 for my
magic
scrolls.
I could have
stolen
your... Yes, I could have.
That would have made a huge difference.
Oh, humongous. That one seems a little ridiculous. I don't really care for... That's, once again, going back to the dick move. You know, it's like, I don't appreciate
somebody
doing it. We don't
like being mean.
Well, because that feels like I have no control.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Whereas you just had this free card that you played down... And you're able to just take something that I had to build and work hard for. Mm-hmm. And all I'm getting compensated for is 3 gems that I may not even be able to use. So that I don't really care for. Then there's some other ones where, like I said, the balance doesn't necessarily
feel
there. Yeah,
some of
the
law
cards
feel like they don't really help you all that much. I tend to discard them for the, you know, 2 gems.
But
and then some of them are awesome. So
and some are awesome. But that is probably the only negative I have about the game is the balance of the law cards. Once I really start understanding how well some of these work, I'm going to probably take some of them out when we play. Because I just feel like they create an unbalance for whoever would own that card.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, phenomenal game. I think the production's really good in this game as well. I think the artwork is beautiful. The cards can be a tad bit flimsy, but it doesn't bother me in the slightest. The tokens, well done all around. This game, man, guys, I can't stress it enough. This is one of the ones I'm so proud to own. Love it. Absolutely love it. Anything else you want to add? Are you done?
There you have it.
There you have it. All right, so Viceroy, it's Mayday Games. Thanks a lot for sending it to us. Check it out. Make sure you guys check this one out because it is definitely hot on my list. Thanks for watching.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.